Welcome to the Solar Energy Channel, where you're going to get an honest, inside look at all things solar. My name is Charles.
And I'm Warren. And in this video, we're going to talk about soiling and shading and how that impacts your solar production and potentially your warranties. Before we jump into the content, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel so you'll get notified of future videos just like this. So Charles, let's talk first of all about shading and how we calculate shading and how we apply that to the production.
Sure. So we take a shade analysis and we use something called a solar pathfinder at the exact location of where the array is going to be. And we take that calculation and put it into our computer modeling software, and that gives us a shade analysis that can accurately then produce the kilowatt hours that system's going to generate. The challenge is that over time, especially as it relates to shade and specifically trees, as those trees grow, there could be increased shade and lowering your production of your solar project.
Correct. So if you have a solar array and we do a shade analysis before your solar gets installed, we can show you what that solar is going to produce based on the shading at that moment in time. 10 years later, you may have much more shading, which would substantially decrease the production of your solar.
Right. You could install a system with no shade today, and as trees grow, you know, you could have significant shade in the future. That can also be on a ground mount system. The impacts could be greater.
Sure.
For shade. The other piece, Warren, as you said, is soiling. So soiling is a phenomenon that happens, believe it or not, as over time, dirt and just dust and pollen become a part of the surface of your panel, and it actually reduces the ability of your panel to produce power.
And that soiling can come from a variety of different places. It can be from pollen in the springtime, but it can also be from external factors. If you have a ground mount that's next to a dirt road and trucks go by, or if you have a woodworking shop or maybe a barn with a low roof, a place where soil or pollen can accumulate and create a thin film that prevents light from getting through to the panels.
Right. Typically, we tell people that they're not going to have to wash their panels, and it's typically true in a standard environment, I'm going to say, where your panel is tilted, your rain is naturally going to wash that soiling, that pollen off of the panel. But where you have a flatter roof or a panel that's not as tilted, your rain is not going to be as naturally a washing mechanism for that panel. And if you're in a dirty environment, you are going to see soiling a part of the impact of your system.
And it's really important to know as well that if your solar company sold you a solar system and they have a production guarantee, that if you allow soiling to accumulate, you're probably going to void your warranty. It is your responsibility to make sure that you keep your panels. If you do have excess, the rain should wash it away. But if you have excess soiling, it is your responsibility to get that cleaned off your panels.
Right. At Paradise, we do calculate a percent of soiling into the production. But where there is more than what would be standard, a significant amount of soiling, that would be something we can't control. So that would be the responsibility of the customer, and it will void what we call our triple 10 guarantee, which we do discuss in other videos, but it's where we guarantee the production of the system for 10 years.
Yep. So in summary, you really want to have as little shade as possible for as long as possible and as little soiling as possible as well to get the maximum production out of your solar array.
Thank you for watching this video. We hope you found this content very useful. Please leave comments in the section below. We'd love to hear feedback from you.